Welcome, dear students, to our English class of Standard 10th. Today's lesson, Unbeatable Supermom Mary Kom, provides a peek into the life of the only Indian woman boxer who is credited with qualifying and winning a bronze in the 51 kg flyweight category at the 2012 Olympics. This lesson includes her interview with a Sportskeeda reporter, Taruka Srivastava, in which she shares her moments of happiness, pride, anxiety, concerns, and aspirations. Unbeatable Supermom Mary Kom. Chungnejung Mary Kom was born on 24th November 1982. Better known as Mary Kom, is an Olympic Indian boxer hailing from the Kom tribe in Manipur. She is a five-time world amateur boxing champion and the only woman boxer to have won a medal in each of the six world champion. Nicknamed Magnificent Mary, she is the only Indian woman boxer to have qualified for the summer 2012 Summer Olympics, competing in the flyweight 51 kg category and winning the bronze medal. Mary Kom hails from, that is, belongs to the Kom tribe in Manipur. The Kom are a community of people mainly found in Manipur, Tripura, Mizoram, and Northeast India. They live mainly on hunting and terrain cultivation. The life of Mangtay Chungnejung Mary Kom, known commonly as Mary Kom, is no less than a fairy tale. Though she was born in a poor family in the village in Manipur, Mary was bold enough to take up boxing and continues to remain the undisputed mistress of the ring. There had to be one successful story if Indians were to survive in sports, and we have that story now. Enough has been said about this great warrior who had conquered the world. This warrior is none other than Mary Mangtay Kom, the conqueror and the comrade. She is famous as a five times world boxing champion and the only boxer to win a medal in every one of the six world championships. In the 2012 Olympics, she became the first Indian woman boxer to qualify and win a bronze medal in the 51 kg flyweight category of boxing. Now, flyweight is a class in boxing in which includes fighters weighing above 49 kg and up to 51 kg. Kom's medal record at the Women's World Championship levels is nothing short of astonishing. In total, the Indian boxer has come home with a medal at no less than 8 editions of the championships. Her first came as a callow, that is, young 18-year-old at the very first Women's World Championships held in USA back in 2001. Boxing at the 48 kg level, Kom claimed a silver medal. The following year saw the start of Kom's golden run as she was crowned world champion for the first time. Kom was seemingly untouchable, and by 2010 she had won 5 world titles in a row. Then came her biggest moment of all, success on the Olympic stage. With women's boxing making a debut at London 2012, Kom once again found herself as a pioneer for the sports in India. But with the chance to box for Olympic glory came a change. Kom had to step up a weight class. Moving from her customary 46 to 51 kg category, She seemed to take the shift in her stride. As she moved through the semi-finals without much difficulty, but the home favorite, Nicola Adams, proved to be too hot to handle. Combs' run was ended. However, her exploits had earned her a bronze medal and another slice of history had been made. Combs was born in Kangthai village, Moirang Lamkhai, in Churanchandpur district of rural Manipur in eastern India. She came from a poor family and her parents, Mangte Tonpa Kom and Mangte Akam Kom, were tenant farmers who worked in jhum fields. Kom grew up in humble surroundings, helping her parents with farm-related chores, going to school and learning athletics initially and later boxing simultaneously. Her father was a keen wrestler in his younger age. Mary Combs was born on March 1, 1983 in Kangthai village, Moirang Lamkhai in Churanchandpur district of rural Manipur in India. She came from a poor family. Her parents, Mangte Tongpa Kom and Mangte Akam Kom, were tenant farmers who worked in jhum fields. She got married to Onla in the year 2005. Now students, let us understand the concept of jhum fields or shifting cultivation.
Since the time of our ancestors, we have been planting crops, hunting, and doing gathering. We have always relied on the forest for everything and have always protected it and nurtured it in return. When we do subsistence farming, we shift fields periodically. Let me tell you how we farm our crops. First, using our ancestral knowledge, we look at the surrounding trees and plants to tell us if the soil is fertile and ready for growing our crop. Then, we perform rituals to see if powerful spirits live in the area. If they do, then we farm somewhere else. We don't want to upset the spirits. Once we've chosen a small plot, we'll clear it all together with machetes. In March, we burn the dead plants. The nutrients in the ashes make the soil naturally fertile and help the harvest to be good. After the harvest, we leave the area for several years so the soil regenerates. The fields attract all kinds of birds and animals who benefit from the clearing. The forest that grows back will be as strong and healthy and will protect the land from erosion. Look at the forest around us. To you, it looks like a wilderness, lush, green, and untouched. But this is our home. And it's like this because we've cared for it and managed it since the beginning of time.
She had an eager instinct in athletics since childhood, and the success of Dingo Singh, a fellow Manipuri returned from the 1998 Bangkok Asian Games with the gold medal, Combs recollects had inspired many youngsters in Manipur to try boxing, and she thought of giving it a try. Mary Combs' career started in 2000 after her victory in the Manipur State Women's Boxing Championship and the Regional Championship in West Bengal in 2001. She started competing at international level. She was only 18 years old, and when she made her international debut at the first AIBA Women's World Boxing Championship in United States, winning a silver medal in the 48 kg weight category. Her greatness is reinforced by the way she apologized to the whole nation for not being able to win the gold. She is a legend for sure, an idol for all the sportswomen to look up to. Since boxing is considered unsuitable for women, Mary Kom never told her parents that she was picking up boxing. They came to know about her interest through a newspaper when she won the Manipur Games Championship in 2000. Ever since she was young, she was interested in athletics. But the success of Dinko Singh, an Indian boxer from Manipur, in 1998 Asian Games ignited passion in Mary Kom and inspired her to enhance her boxing skills and take up professional boxing. Mary Kom decided to give up studies and enter into the ring with determination and strong will. She joined Sports Authority of India, Kuman Lumpak in Manipur, and underwent intensive training from coach and mentor Imbota Singh to pursue her dream of becoming a world-class boxer. Later on, the encouragement and infrastructure support from the Manipur Boxing Association became a turning point for Mary Kom. In an exclusive interview with Sportskeeda correspondent Taruka Srivastava, Olympic bronze medalist Mary Kom talked about her preparation for the Olympics and her elation at winning a medal. Interviewer, first things first, you're the first Indian female boxer to win an Olympics medal for India. Has the feeling completely sunk in? Mary Kom, I'm really happy with my achievement. And yes, it is yet to sink in. I'm just so exhilarated. Interviewer, you were the only female representative from India in boxing. Did that put additional pressure on you? Mary Kom, no, not at all. I was pretty confident about myself. I knew. Interviewer, your coach Charles Atkinson was not allowed to accompany you to the Olympics. How did that affect your preparations? Mary Kom, well, I did miss him there, but thankfully we had already done our homework and I was well prepared. Now Sportskeeda is a sports news website which has news, features, commentary and videos on sports. The name of the website is derived from a colloquial Hindi term, that is, the sporting equivalent to the word bookworm. Sportskeeda literally translates to sportsworm in English. You know, Mary Kom is the only Indian female boxer to win an Olympic medal. She clinched a bronze medal in 51 kg category in 2012, defeating Britain's Nicola Adams. She says that she is so exhilarated, which means very thrilled, that she has yet to sink in, meaning that she was so happy that she could not believe that she has won an Olympic medal. Also, Charles Atkinson had been her coach for almost a year for the Olympics. This American coach could not join her at the Olympic Village as he did not have an International Boxing Association, that is AIBA, 3-star certification, which is a prerequisite for accreditation. Thus, she was forced to train on her own in Liverpool. Naturally, the then 29-year-old Mary was upset over the incident, but then she was well prepared. Interviewer, during your preparations for the Olympics, you sparred with the male boxers of the Indian contingent. Who was your favorite sparring partner? Mary Kom laughs. Well, I trained hard in Pune and the male boxers were kind enough to practice with me whenever I required them. To name a favorite would be unfair. Now, way back, Mary competed in 48 kg before the Amateur International Boxing Association, that is AIBA, scrapped the weight class from the Olympics before shifting to 51 kg, a category in which she won bronze at the 2010 Asian Games. At that time, she did not have much experience in the 51 kg category. It had just been 1 year or so since she had changed her weight category, before which she used to compete in 48 kg, in which she had won all world championship titles. In 51 kg, she was facing taller boxers and they had better reach. There were not many female boxers in India with this kind of height. So, for training in the 51 kg category at 2012 Olympics, she trained with boys who were taller and heavier than her after her qualification was confirmed. Since she was training for the Olympics, she didn't mind getting hit. Now, here, sparring partner means a person with whom you practice boxing. Interviewer, you were quoted saying Adams was very clever, a counterpuncher, but although she carried power, she wasn't very tactical. I was scoring, but the judges were not pressing the buttons. Do you think dodgy judging was part of the reason for your loss in the semi-finals? Mary Kom, yes, I think some of the decisions were unfortunate and did not work to my benefit. Interviewer, India managed just 6 medals in the 2012 Olympics, even though we are a nation of 1.3 billion people. Where do you think a change is required to get help us win medals that are proportionate with our population? Mary Kom, I think more and more people should take up sports as a full-time career if we want more gold medals. More corporates should come in and sponsor players so that the players don't have any financial pressure and can just focus on their games. You know, the last 3 rounds were close, but the 3-1 gap that Nicola Adam opened up in the first round made the real difference. And with each passing round after that, Mary Kom kept lagging behind. It was Mary's 5 feet 2 inches frame that became her undoing as Nicola used her big body and greater reach to a good effect, landing punches from a distance and then also staying out of her opponent's reach. India is a nation of 1.3 billion people, which is a fifth of globe's population. Despite this fact, we managed only 6 medals in 2012 Olympics. On this, Mary says that for more gold medals, more people should take up sports as a full-time career, because in India, most families would prefer their children to become dentists or accountants than Olympians. One of the reasons why India isn't punching its weight in Olympics is money. Despite its space program and burgeoning population of billionaires, India is still a very poor nation in terms of per capita income, and sports, with an exception to cricket, has never been a priority for the government. According to Shiva Keshavar, who is India's greatest winner Olympian. So, sponsors and corporates funding the talented athletes would definitely change the scenario. Interviewer, do you think interest in boxing in India will ever go beyond the Olympics? Mary Kom, yes, I'm sure that in few years, Boxing will be a very popular among everyone in India all the year round. Interviewer, how aware are Indian women of their nutritional requirements? Diet and nutrition must have been a key factor in your conditioning for the Olympics. Do you think nutrition is a neglected area in Indian sports? Mary Kom, the awareness is growing now among the female athletes when it comes to nutritional requirements. Nutrition has definitely been a neglected area in Indian sports. I had to gain 3 kgs since I had to fight in the 51 kg event instead of the usual 48 kgs that I fight in. So, I had to focus on what to eat. I gained weight by eating the right kind of food rather than bad saturated fats. See, athletes train long hours for their sport. In order to optimize that training, proper nutrition needs to be a regular component of their workout plan. Just as a car needs fuel to run properly, so do athletes need a healthy eating plan. As it helps them in strengthening of the immune system, decrease muscle tiredness, helps in muscle healing, improves energy levels and increased focus and attention span. We definitely get to see the awareness about nutritional requirements among the athletes nowadays. Interviewer, how big a role did OGQ play in shaping the boxing scene in India for the better? Mary Kom, OGQ really played an important part in my success. They helped me out whenever I needed something. They took care of everything, which helped me focus on my boxing and kept me stress-free. Interviewer, what's your opinion on the future of Indian boxing? Mary Kom, the future is very bright and I am sure many more boxers will get medals for us. Now, Olympic Gold Quest, that is OGQ, is a program of the Foundation for Promotion of Sports and Games, a not-for-profit company founded by sporting legends Geet Sethi and Prakash Padukone. Yes, Deepika Padukone is his daughter. The mission of OGQ is to support the Indian athletes in winning Olympic gold medals. You know, in the last two Olympics, 5 out of 8 medal winners for India were supported by OGQ. It was OGQ that helped Mary Kom to move 2 weight categories from 46 kg to 51 kg smoothly. They founded a world-class coach in Charles Atkinson for Mary, and he really helped her with better strategy against taller and stronger opponents. OGQ arranged 4 training camps in Pune and 1 in Liverpool under Charles in coordination with IABF, which were fully funded by Sports Ministry. Dr. Nikhil Latte, her head of the OGQ sports medicine team, has been with Mary for over 2 years to help her with fitness, recovery and strength. They had also arranged for travel and accommodation for domestic tournaments. Given today's scenario, Mary feels that the future of Indian boxing is really very bright. Interviewer, do you find it difficult to convince your children not to fight when they watch you go out and do it in style all the time? Mary Kom, well, I have twins and yes, sometimes it becomes really difficult to keep them under control. Interviewer, will you train your kids to become boxers as well? Mary Kom, I haven't really thought about it. As of now, just let their mother box. Interviewer, you have broken several stereotypes and about the women in India by showing that women can compete with men in any field. But how good are you at the traditional feminine activities like cooking? Mary Kom, well, I am good at cooking and other household work too. Interviewer, would you be interested in coaching Indian women in boxing one day? Mary Kom, let's see, in the future, maybe yes. Interviewer, what do you prefer being called? Super mom or super boxer? Mary Kom, I love being a mom. That's the best thing that has ever happened to me. Mary Kom is a legend now. Her success has not only brought so many laurels to the nation, but continued to motivate us through her hard work and never say die attitude. Currently, the ace boxer is grooming younger talents at her home state Manipur. She is providing free boxing skills to our little children. The Samaritan approach of Mary makes her a legend in the true sense. Magnificent Mary is a proud mom today of three children. Mary played her roles as a perfect woman, daughter, sister, mother, and a loving wife. Her family life couldn't stop her from accomplishing medals for the nation. She has fulfilled her responsibility impeccably at both her professional and family life. In spite of being an inspiration to the millions and having attained the status of a youth icon as she stepped her foot in the world of boxing, she proudly prefers to be known as Super Mom. When the film Mary Kom was released featuring Bollywood actress Priyanka Chopra, the film had been critically acclaimed and the audience got their eyes filled with tears while coming out of the theaters. You can now very well imagine the pain with which the real Mary went through in her actual life. So, we are done with the lesson. Hope you understood it. Thank you.